I grew up in a small little city where the population was about 5,000 people, only few cars. We ourselves did not have a car. We depend on public transportation. 1987, 1988, I was about to finish high school, and a couple of my friends came to the United States, and you know, they told me how life was and how this was a great country. And one day visiting my brother in Rio de Janeiro, we passed through the American consulate, and he showed me a huge line, people applying for visas. And I said to him, I'm going to come back here. I'm coming back here, and I'm applying for a visa. And he said to me, no, you're not going to get a visa. Well, people from my home state don't get visas. And I like, you'll see. When I arrived at Boston in 1988, it was snow up to my knees. I had a little jacket that my father had given to me, that in Brazil, we don't wear jackets. The little light jacket, thinking that it's going to be enough to cover the cold. So I said to myself, where am I going to? With the trees, no leaves on the trees, all this white stuff on the floor. And it was a little scary, to be honest with you. And as I arrived, I had to walk 3 blocks because the people that came to pick me up at the airport didn't have, the car was far away. And I was dying. I was freezing. Like, I don't think I'm going to last long. And I'm going to go back to Brazil pretty soon. For 7 months, I had 3 jobs. I would have Sunday mornings off to pretty much go to the dry cleaner and wash my clothes, the laundry mop. And that was it, you know, no time for anything. I did that. I was able to, you know, pay my father back for the trip, that, you know, the money that he gave me. And I remember working as a day porter, sort of like a security guard in a building in Boston, where I didn't speak a word of the English, and some of the secretaries would stop by and say hi, try to teach me English. Plus, I had a walkie-talkie that I had to use it without speaking the language. So I would pay attention to my boss then talking to one of the maintenance workers, and then calling him, and he would say, oh yeah, I'll be right over, 10-4. So I started repeating stuff, you know, and that's how I learned the language. You wouldn't see a Brazilian on the train. You'd take a train. When you'd see a Brazilian, it was like, you know, you just found a brother. You know, you'd go to them and hug them and say hi. Today, there's so many of them that I don't think they want to see one another on the train. This is Brazilian Total Assistance, a non-profit community organization that we founded to help the Brazilian community assimilate to the American culture. And also, you know, help Americans, employers, you know, with the translations. They need access to, you know, services, whether it's a social or health services. We try to refer them to those professionals that can help them.
Tá? O nome da própria Alex Simmovin está registrado junto com o Better Business Bureau, está com o Federal Trade Commission, está registrado em todo mundo lado. Sabe? Então fica tão difícil para eles agora funcionar, porque, na verdade, a resposta que eles têm dado...
They have children, or they have elderly parents in Brazil, and, you know, they're sending stuff down there to make the life of their relatives better. And these people are stymieing that effort.
It makes me feel kind of hopeful, you know, that they will do something about it.
It's natural. It's something that I love doing it. Whether it's helping an American or a Brazilian or Chinese, it doesn't matter. As long as I'm helping, being able to help somebody, you know, achieve whatever they're looking to achieve, it makes us happy. The last 3 years, Latinos as a whole has become the scapegoat to people being unemployed. A lot of people don't want to work, and they blame newcomers. It's very prejudicial. I learned the language, you know, I became a citizen, and I was given the right tools, you know, and then I was able to do, you know, good for society as a whole. I think if people are provided with the proper tools, they will also do that. And I think and that's what I hope that will happen eventually.
Estão a caminho do destino final no Espírito Santo.